Good morning and praise the Lord. For the last 2 days, we have attempted to look at how we can get to our destinies. We have considered two biblical accounts. The first was the life of Joseph and the account of the four lepers as recorded in Genesis 37 and 2 Kings chapter 7, respectively. My name is Kevin Kamotho, and our sign language interpreter is Gray Ngugi. Today we are going to consider living with a heavenly perspective. You're going to draw our reflections from the book of Colossians, chapter 3. We'll look at verse 1 to 17, and I'll invite you at your own free time to read through the passage. You know, friends, it is worth noting that God has not just called us to fulfill a great destiny here on earth. He desires that we live with a heavenly perspective. He desires that we live in light of eternity. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 11b, that he has set eternity in our hearts. Living with a heavenly perspective means living in light of eternity. It is acknowledging that there is another life after this life here on earth. And you know, friends, the next phase of life, that's eternity, is premised on how we live now and the choices we make here on earth. Rick Warren, in his popular book, The Purpose-Driven Life, says this, and I quote, "This life is not all there is. Life on earth is just the dress rehearsal before the real production. You will spend far more time on the other side of death in eternity than you will here. Earth is a staging arena, the preschool, the tryout for your life in eternity. It is a practice workout before the actual game, the warm-up lap before the race begins. This life is preparation for the next." End of quote. We'll base our reflection this morning, as I've mentioned, on the book of Colossians chapter 3, verse 1 to 17. You know, brothers and sisters, when we live in light of eternity, it shapes three areas of our lives. It shapes our choices, it shapes our conduct, and it also shapes our contribution. The first one, when you choose to live in light of eternity, it gets to shape the choices that we make. In verse 1 all the way to 4 of Colossians, Apostle Paul gets to explain true Christian behavior. He points out that true Christian behavior means putting on the new nature by accepting Christ and regarding the earthly nature as dead. He points out that this is a matter of choice, not a matter of chance. You know, friends, living in the light of eternity will affect the choices you make. It helps you to come to realization that your choices here on earth have an eternal bearing. In verse 2 of Colossians chapter 3, Paul encourages the church the believers to set their sight on heavenly realities. And that basically means striving to put heaven's priority and choices into everyday practice. The second thing that is shaped by the decision that we make to live with a heavenly perspective is that it gets to shape our conduct. And we see these from verse 5 all the way to verses 15. Living with a heavenly perspective helps to shape our conduct. It informs what we do, what we say, where we go, the company we keep, the conversations we engage in. It affects everything about our lives. For you and I to be able to acquire the heavenly, or what I call the Christian conduct, we must choose to do two things. Number one, we must willfully and deliberately choose to put to death earthly conduct and mindset. You know, it demands laying aside sin and all that which is anti-God. Paul, in verse 5, all the way to 11, talks to the church and tells the church to put to death the things that are of earthly nature. For you and I to have that Christian conduct, then we must put to death the earthly mindset. But secondly, we must also put on the nature of Christ and what I call the kingdom mindset. And in verse 12, the Bible says this: "Therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, and in verse 13, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If anyone has a complaint against another, even as Christ forgave you, so you also must do." So Paul here is saying, yes, put to death the earthly conduct and the earthly mindset, but also put on the nature of Christ and the kingdom mindset. You know, friends, our conduct is dependent on the mindset we subscribe to. So for us to live with a heavenly perspective, we must appreciate that it gets to shape our choices, it shapes our conduct, but lastly, it also gets to shape our contribution. And we'll draw our reflection on that from verse 15 to 17. You know, friends, our contribution has to do with what we do and how we do it, and the impact we create in our areas of influence. Friends, when we live in light of eternity, our work, assignments, careers, and possessions become vehicles for ministry through which God is honored and glorified. In verse 17 of Colossians chapter 3, Paul says this: "And whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God the Father through him." You know, our contribution is about what we get to do with what God has given us. It's the impact we create where God has stationed us. I'm sure you must have heard this quote When people are referring to someone who's maybe spiritual, they say that he's too heavenly minded, that he's of no use, of no earthly use. But I think that's really wrong, because for us to be of any earthly use, we must be heavenly minded. Our lives here on earth, brothers and sisters, are a preparation for eternity. Matthew Henry says this: it ought to be the business of every day to prepare for our final day. My friends, living with a heavenly perspective will shape your choices, it will shape your conduct, and it will shape your contribution. My prayer for you today and for the remaining part of the great life that God has in store for you is that you will live in light of eternity. You will remember that this life is a dress rehearsal for the next. Remember that living with a heavenly perspective shapes your choices, it shapes your conduct, and it shapes your contribution. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for the sharing of your word, for reminding us that you've called us to live with eternity in mind. Lord, I pray that you'll help each and every one of us who's watching and listening to desire to live a life that honors you, to desire to live with a heavenly perspective. I pray for the young and the old alike, that you will set their hearts on fire for you, and that through the power of the Holy Spirit, they will bring change and transformation in the areas of our influence. So we submit to you, our God and our Father, and we pray for your grace and for your blessings. For this is our prayer, in Jesus' name, amen.